What is the best thing about your job?
It's very fulfilling to see development taking place and the joy it brings to particularly people that have been disadvantaged. I've actually been at ceremonies where we hand over keys to people who've never had access to decent housing, where we've switched on taps, where we've switched on lights to people, been where we've actually created job opportunities for people. This really motivates me, inspires me.
And how has Durban changed over the last 38 years with you in the city administration? I mean, the city must have changed a lot.
Indeed. What's really very exciting for me is the journey that we've come through in terms of democracy. We've seen a lot of legislation come in. We've seen the transformation that goes with a new era, and it's been exciting.
What is probably the most impactful experience that you've had in your job?
I really like to go out. It's a learning experience for me. And what we take for granted, sitting in our so-called ivory tower, It makes such a difference when you go out there. And each time I've gone site visits, whether it's to a refuse dump site, a wastewater treatment plant, an aqueduct that we've just put in for hydroelectricity, it really makes me appreciate the other side of life. It just is such a wonderful experience to actually know that the fruits of your labor is counted for. And local government, it's where the rubber hits the road. It's where the action is. You're dealing with real people. There are 3.7 million people living in my city, and every one of them do not enjoy the same quality of life. There's a lot of inequality. There's a lot of unemployment. And for me, it's my dream over the next 2 or 3 years that I may have left in my career to see a lot of the actual processes put in place to meet that.
What would Durban look like in your ideal world in 2.5 or 3 years?
Lisa, I'd like to see all our issues around smart city coming together. I hope that the plans that we have in terms of creating this more dense, compact city with viable public transport comes to light. All of our initiatives around the environment also fulfilled in terms of reducing refuse and how we recycle. The issue around the wastewater treatment plants and how we modernize that and make them more energy efficient, our green building programs. When I'm in retirement in 20 years from now, I hope to see all these plans come to fruition and that we've got far better air quality, that we could actually enjoy a longer life and that we reduce the incidence of a whole lot of ill health that is prevailing. Lastly, it's about water. South Africa has been hit with a lot of drought. So for me, it's about how we manage water more carefully as a resource. I'd really like to see a very productive city with reduced unemployment and an improved quality of life for all.
Are there any life lessons that you've learned from your job?
When I started off work, I was a workaholic. In fact, when we got married, my wife keeps on reminding me that we never went on honeymoon. Virtually the next day, we're in the middle of doing a set of financial statements, I was back at work. But it's taught me that we need to strike that balance in everything that we do. I think also the spiritual side of life has actually supported me. I'm very conscious of the fact that we need to deliver and that we need to actually give off our best in everything that we do. If you ask my wife what she thinks about me, she will say that we've come a long way and she's happy to go all the way. I come from a faith that believes in reincarnation, and she'll say she'll probably be happy to spend the next birth with me.
That's a great aspiration. So where will you retire?
I'll give you one guess, Lisa.
You grew up in Durban, you've worked in Durban, and you'll retire in Durban.
Absolutely. It's a lovely city. Every 2 years, I go up to a spiritual retreat up in the Himalaya. So I'd like to spend perhaps 2 or 3 weeks in the year there. But home will always be Durban.
I love the spiritual element that you bring to your work. It's actually very inspiring for me because I relate to it.
Lisa, perhaps that's why we get along so well.
And maybe I'll see you in the Himalayas.
Absolutely.